Hi, how's it going? You are listening to the Dew Sweepers. Now listen, the Dew Sweepers is all about that early morning, okay? We're talking golf, we're talking life. Every Wednesday when the sun comes up, you know the Dew Sweepers are going to be there for you. Clever name, Dew Sweepers, if you think about it. The dew is on the grass in the morning, you see. And these guys are sweeping it up. Morning. Birds. Get the worm. And the worms are all about the Dew Sweepers. Every Wednesday, you should be listening. And since you are listening, you're about to enjoy the hell out of what you're about to hear. Have a great day. Cheers.
We are live, but not live. From the green side. Let's just fucking do it tomorrow, Austin. Me and Austin will do it tomorrow. I'm not
Austin and I.
Gonna do it. Do it live.
Fuck it.
So did you guys catch the like where we can
Well you said it twice. That's why
I because Kane was talking when I said so the first time, he's like, fuck a goat, or something like that when he was saying it the first time.
What? Oh, I'm sorry, that was just my Tourette's. Yeah.
Fuck a goat.
Holy shit.
Fuck a go.
So the off weekend of golf, did you guys catch the US amateur or the Wyndham at all? Do you guys watch any of that?
I had the Wyndham on in the background last week at work, but I think the only thing I really saw was Siwoo Kim not celebrating an ace and then getting more excited about his almost second hole in one in the same round. Did you guys see that?
I didn't see his almost second one. No. What happened?
He
almost made it again.
I knew you were going to say that, Kim. Explain the hole, Dean, since you've seen it.
It was a decent, pretty longer par three. I think like 190.
Pretty longer.
Pretty longer.
He absolutely stuffed one, and he put like a little left to right spin on it, and it completely just rolled over the hole. And he had a bigger reaction for that than the one he actually made to take the lead earlier in the day.
He still lost. He lost. He probably lost because
I had him in my DraftKings.
Celebrate
my lineup. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I did.
So real quick. John, one of your picks for the week was Lanto Griffin.
I was going to get to this.
I don't think he played.
No, he didn't. I realized after the day after you guys wouldn't change it.
After you guys gave me shit.
Because Dean picked Tony Finau.
I didn't have to change it either.
So we're doing great. We definitely know our golf that two of our guys
any
are
points done. No negative, no positive.
There should be a penalty for picking something he didn't play.
So I was thinking about that today when I got home from work.
Yeah, I might just pick one guy.
Right?
Yeah, seriously. I'm just going to pick one guy on like the first page. And it's going to be the same guy until, you know.
I was just thinking of being the bigger man and taking like a 5-stroke penalty for having a player picked that didn't play. But obviously.
We would have had we would have had to discuss this beforehand. I didn't think any of us would be dumb enough to pick a golfer who's not playing in the week, honestly. But
well, it didn't happen until after the fact, though. Like, it was the day of. I'm pretty sure he withdrew that morning.
No, John was 100% safe. It was my dumbass that used the control F on my Bovada, and I typed in Finau to see if he was playing, and it just pulled me to a future page, and it just, to me, it looked like he was in the field.
Oh, well, John can't do anything if the player withdraws. Like, it just happens, like, it withdraws, but, like,
there was a couple
Finau wasn't even listed. Yeah, it's just a different situation there, but yeah, no. I got you.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Definitely not disagreeing with that at all. Do we want to go over the picks right away, since we're kind of on that?
Sucked sure, yeah, I don't remember who I even
did. Yeah, neither do I.
So, John, you claim you don't remember, but again, you had the best weekend out of all of us.
What the fuck?
You had Kevin Kisner, who fired off an 18 under par, Henrik Norlander, who fired 5 under, and then Lanto Griffin, I put a couple question marks because I was actually sitting here prepping for the show, and I look at Austin. I'm like, did Lanto Griffin even play this weekend? He's like, yeah, John picked him. And I was like, I can't find him on the leaderboard. He's like, I don't know. I thought he played. So, John, you fired off a 23 total this weekend, bringing your yearly total to 182 under par. I had the third best weekend with Tony Finau not playing. Paul Casey, 9 under, Tommy Fleetwood, 5 under, 14 for the weekend, 122 season so far. Tom had an okay weekend, Paul Casey, 9 under, Corey Connors, 1 under, and then he had Austin Cook fire 1 over. I think he made the cut and then battled to 1 over par for the weekend, bringing his weekend total to 9 and season to 111. Austin had the worst weekend out of all of us. Yay. With Justin Rose and Wyndham Clark both firing off an even par, and your boy Jay Spieth 2 under, bringing your season total to 80 under par. And we had a little flip flop. Cam took over the 4 spot, where you had Webb Simpson 18 under, Brendan Todd 2 under, and then Ryan Moore 2 under. So 22 under for the weekend, that's bringing cool. your season total to 85. So
I see a trend here. The 2 best totals on the week only had 2 golfers playing.
No, Cam was second.
Cam had 3.
He had 3.
Go yeah. for it, Austin. I think you should do it. Only pick like 2 guys, maybe even 1.
I might just pick 1 off the top. Well, no, because this field's pretty stacked. So you can get some good players in the second and third groupings because it's the FedEx Cup playoffs now. So
correct. So the new standings are as follows. John, you are still in first at 182 under par. I am in second at 122. Tom is firing off an 111. Cam, you are at 85. And Austin, you are bringing up the rear at 80 under par.
So really quick, I don't think we've discussed this. I don't care personally, just asking. Majors, you get 50 under if you predict a correct one. That's right.
Did you just have a stroke?
I'm just, you know, confirming. We agree on that.
Yes, but that's not how you said it.
What about the PGA Championship or the Tour Championship?
It's not a major.
Are we no caveats for that?
No, just normal score.
Winner, right?
No, I'm good.
Okay, just like I said, I don't care either way. Just wanted to ask now instead of asking after the tournament while one of us picks the winner.
Okay, who is it going to be? We might as well do it. We might as well pick now before the playoffs start. All right, who's going to win the Tour Championship? Pull up a list. Here you go. No,
it's got anybody in those 3 pages. I mean, it's just 3 pages.
No, but the Tour Championship isn't this week. Yeah,
I understand. I'm talking about like when the playoffs start, not like picking when there's 30 guys out there. That's no fun.
Oh, so, yeah, we're like picking right now for who's going to win the Tour Championship.
Sure.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm like JT, like he's up there. What is he at, second in the FedEx Cup or first, whatever? He's obviously going to be a favorite for it. And I'd have a hard time picking against him because he just won the other week, too. JT? Yeah, I'd feel comfortable with JT. That's a safe bet. He's number 1 right now.
Is the Tour Championship every year at Eastlake?
Yes.
I'm going to go with Bryson. I'm going to take Bryson.
I'm taking Colin.
Mark Allen. Like
that's who I'm taking too, is Colin.
Yep.
And Tom is going to take Zach Blair.
No, give Tom Patrick Reed. He's 6th.
Yes.
All right, hold on. Let me write this down.
Paul Casey. He's a big Paul Casey fan. Give him Paul Casey.
No, he wants Patrick Reed.
Paul Casey's dead to him, he said.
Even though he picked him the next week.
So this is the Tour Championship picks?
Yeah.
Tom, we're giving Reed, right? Mm-hmm. Austin, you said you're taking...
Justin Thomas.
JT. I'm taking Bryson. Then Cam and John, you are both taking Colin Morikawa?
Correct. Yes.
Oh, and Cameron, did you know that 1 year ago today, we went to the BMW? Me, you, and Dean.
Know what that means? Even more importantly, 1 year ago today, you had Vito and Nick's pizza.
I know. I miss it.
They're taking franchise opportunities. Sounds like a good venture for a capitalist investment, right?
I don't know how that's going to honestly work out.
I don't think. Can you even make a lot of money in the restaurant business?
Yeah. I mean, the quick answer is yes, of course. However, it's very difficult.
Right now, right?
Well, I would say
in general, it is.
In general, yeah. It's very difficult. But
I think like the average length for a restaurant to stay open is like 7 years. is all the longer like the average restaurant stays open.
Do you think that do you think that's in part though? Like, is there a certain amount of time to where if you get past it, you're like the odds you're gonna stay open are pretty good? But there's just so many restaurants that fail right away that brings that average way down.
Probably right.
Like a curve, a bell curve.
But I think like you look at some golf courses, just like restaurants, they get in a rut and they just do the same thing over and over. And they don't change and they just kind of die off because people find newer and better things to do. So,
anyways, none of us are restaurant entrepreneurs tours. Or anything.
Restaurant tours.
Shall we move on to this week's tournament?
But I was going to say, get the real golf out of the way for the people who actually care before we get too sidetracked about everything else.
So yeah,
go ahead. Give us a little background, Dean.
This weekend, they got the Northern Trust. This year, it's being held at TPC Boston. Fun fact, John, you brought it up in the group chat the other day. Are all TPC courses public? TPC Boston is, in fact, private. So I thought that was really ironic you asked that.
And then the next week, they're playing it.
Yeah, right. It's the original architect was Arnold Palmer. It was redone in 07 by Gil Hans. It's going to be playing around 7,200 yards, par 71. Last year's winner was none other than Mr. Patrick Reed at Liberty National. He fired off a 16 under. 2 years ago, it was Bryson at Ridgewood, 18 under par. And then in 2017, it was Dustin Johnson at Glen Oaks at 13 under par. And another little tidbit, Austin, this one's for you. DJ beat Jordan Spieth in a playoff.
Yeah, do you not remember that on 18 when he just took the water out of the lane and went straight over it?
Yes.
It was like, what, a 500-yard par 4. And he just cut the corner over the water and he had like 30 yards into the green.
I just remember you sitting there and be like, this is why it's not fair to compare people off the tee. Because he just absolutely manhandled that hole because of that line.
Well, yeah, it was insane, and that's when you first really saw the margin between the guys who bomb at 150,000 yards and the guys who can't.
I think, didn't they, like, try and cut to him, and he was, like, already pulling his club back, too? Like, wasn't he already set, knew exactly what he was doing as they were still, as Spieth was, like, trying to decide? You remember that?
Are you talking about Dinah last year?
No, we're talking about the 2017 Northern Trust when DJ just took water out of it.
I remember that.
Yeah.
I think that was like one of the first ever golf tournaments I actually like paid attention to.
Really? That recently?
So now the Northern Trust, this is the first round of the FedEx playoffs, correct?
Yes.
Yes.
And so we have 125.
125.
And then they cut it to 65, I think, and then final 32.
70, I think. 70 and then 35.
Okay.
I think one of the, yeah, they sound
right. Something like
top,
that.
Top 30 getting to the tour championship.
Top 30. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Something like that. So, who we got for picks this week? Austin, what's the order here?
I'm in last, so I go first.
I love hearing
so,
that.
So, I'm going to follow my tour championship pick, and I'm going to pick JT this week. I think he's going to have a great week. You know, try and get in form for the tour championship, followed by a guy who's got to have a good week to get into the tour championship, Jay Spieth. And then wrapping up my picks, I'm going to go with Joel Damon. I feel like he's been had like a sneaky good season so far since the return. No one really talks about him, but I feel like he's top 20 every tournament. But every Sunday, I feel like he's in contention.
Cameron Kelly.
Oh, wow. Must be serious. Use my full name.
Yeah.
Take it. Yeah. No. I don't have one of those. Good try. Taking Big Cat.
Ooh. Is this the first time we've seen him since, what was that?
The PGA.
Last week.
PGA, right? What? So
it's just been a week.
A week removed. Week,
right? Oh, wow. PGA feels like so long ago.
Nope.
What life are you living?
Yeah. I don't know.
See, it's really stupid. Bovada has, what, like eight guys at 5,000?
Yep, can't pick them.
I know. Well, I realize that. How about this? If I can pick two guys, 5,000 or under, or I could pick three guys.
No.
And follow the rules.
No.
Why?
Because I would have done that.
I said I would have given myself a penalty, and you guys said no.
Yeah, there's no need for a penalty because of your stupidity. It's okay.
Exactly.
Yeah, I guess I'll pick Kevin Kisner. Yeah, I don't know. I don't really like any of those picks. And then Russell Henley.
All right. So is Tom in third?
Yep.
So I have Tom's picks. He's going to go with John Rahm, Abraham Ancer. Oh, no. He's going with Tiger Woods, Abraham Ancer, and Ian Poulter.
Tiger, Ancer, and who?
Poulter. Poulter.
Okay. I'm in second, so I'm next. I'm going to go with the defending champ. Yeah, defending champ, Patrick Reed. Cam with the sneaky second pick, Mr. Kevin Kisner. And then third, I'm going to take the guy named ZJ. He had a sneaky good weekend. I think he finished like T5 or something, Zach Johnson. So hopefully keep that good momentum rolling.
Yeah, Kevin Kisner's such a secret pick. He hasn't been picked the most out of anyone this year by Osa.
Has he?
Probably.
They probably, yeah.
Probably tied with your Jordan Spieth picks, right?
Yeah.
No, because Kisner probably more. Because everyone else picks kids here and there.
I'd be willing if I went back and looked. There's more Jordan Spieth on these lists than Kevin Kisner.
I'd take that bet and say you're right, Dean.
All right, Dean.
Let me write down John's picks, and then I'll go back while you guys start chatting.
So I'm going to go with J-Day, then Victor Hovland, and Shane Lowry.
You can't do 10,000. It has to be above 10,000, I thought.
Yeah, it's 10,001 and greater.
5,000 to 10,001?
No.
5,000 to 10,000. Oh, like 5,000 can't be picked in the first grouping.
Yeah, they're the second grouping. And 10,000 is the third grouping. 1 to 499.
Listen.
Don't even get me started, John.
No, it's 1 to 5.
It's 1 to 5.
1 to 10. 10, yeah. 1 plus.
Yes. It's been like this since week one. Okay,
whatever. Then I will take...
Zach Blair, you get Zach Blair.
No, Mark Leishman.
I think Zach Blair is DFL on the statistics or the odds.
Well, why would he not be on the odds if he's playing?
He's got
50,000. He's plus 50,000.
So, okay. Then that's a great payday.
So, should we all put $10 on Zach Blair as a group? Put 50 bucks at
play? Yeah, here. Austin, can I borrow 10 bucks?
What's that yield, Austin?
If we were to put. 50 yeah, bucks.
We put 50 bucks on Zach Blair and
do math.
I don't know how odds work.
No, I'm telling Austin.
It would be math. 25 grand.
Oh my God.
For just 10 bucks or all
a person? 10 bucks.
It would be five. We'd all win 5 grand.
That's hilarious. So, he's not going to fucking win, but that's hilarious.
I think we should all.
Ye have little faith.
That's. When's the last time somebody won a golf tournament that was 25,000 and over?
Oh, Herman?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Jim Herman was way up there.
Really?
Yeah. I want to say he was like 36,000.
All right. So Dean, do you think we have another assignment for you?
Hold on. I'm doing this.
So do you think that like guys that are plus 30,000 and plus 25,000 go on Bovada and put 50 bucks on themselves?
No, they can't.
I think that's illegal.
Is it? Are you betting on yourself?
Are you dumb, John?
Works. Probably sounds illegal. Yeah. What about their caddies?
So Jim Herman was 50,000. Was plus 50,000.
Man, there's 5 G's you just missed, John. Oh, I bet you're kicking yourself.
So yeah. What about what if a caddy does it for the guy he's caddying? Is that still illegal?
That's like a ref betting on a game.
Yeah, it's extremely illegal.
What about the wife?
John, you can't be tied. Haven't you heard like even like
Pete Rose story?
The Pete Rose story, like even the lotto. Himself. No, but even like the exactly. What did you just say? Can you bet on yourself?
It's different. He's the coach. What about a family member?
No.
Family members can't be out of bounds.
No. Yes, they are.
Yeah.
It's just like the lotto. No first, like they've always said, like no first, what's it called? like initial tie
immediate to family.
Immediate family. Thank you.
So is a cousin. Okay.
Is that immediate family? No. So yes, it's okay then.
So what's considered immediate family? Just mom, your dad, wife and kids? Or your mom,
dad, and kids, right?
And brothers and sisters.
Yeah.
And
brothers and sisters. Okay. This is... And that's betting talk. Moving on to our next subject.
So I do think we should all throw $10 on Zach Blair.
Okay.
You do Austin, it for us, spot me. And then I'll pay you back, Austin.
Here, how about this? I'll make you a deal. You eat the $10. I'll borrow it so you can throw it on there. When he wins, I'll give you $500. So boom.
You're I'm down for that.
You get that much more for, you know.
Cam, I would literally rather just put $20 myself than say
$10. Okay, well, I mean, I'm just saying.
Like, why am I going to, instead of getting $5,000, I'd get $500.
I'm just
because
saying.
You're selfish.
What? I'm all taking right. all the risk on. You got to give right. me more than 10% of the payout.
All right, Dean, you got
no, I don't.
I was going to say, while you idiots are discussing the odds and everything, who wants to take a guess at how many times Jordan Spieth was picked this season and how many times Kevin Kisner was picked?
Well, how many weeks seven. Have we made picks?
Seven and nine.
Seven for Spieth or seven for Kiz?
Seven for Spieth.
Okay.
I'm going to say Spieth eight times and Kiz 12.
Okay.
I'm going to say Spieth nine and Kiz eight.
So Spieth was picked eight times this season.
Woo!
Kisner, nine times.
Oh, baby. Did I just get that right?
No, you had
you got
it. Fuck. You're wrong.
I thought I had that right.
You're wrong. Wrong.
So I was right, though, and Kiz was picked more than Spieth.
There was a couple weekends, Austin, where you picked Kisner and Spieth, by the way. But
yeah, I know. I like Kisner.
Oh, geez. So now that we've got this week's tournament out of the way, how's everybody's games coming along? We should revisit the goals for the year. Golf is almost done for the year.
I haven't played in a couple weeks.
That's slacking.
Did you just play with Tom?
Oh, no, I just played last week. I played a local course, Tam, just nine holes. I fired off a 39.
Probably from the ladies' tees.
I hit zero greens, and I hit a 39.
What's the yardage, Austin?
Oh, it's short. The par fours 1500. The par fours are only like 300 yards.
The par fours are 300 yards?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's a really short course. It's a nine hole.
It's narrow, though, so it's a little challenge. Like, you're not hitting more than a five iron off every tee because of how narrow it is.
Yeah.
How long are the par threes? 85 yards?
No.
No, the par threes got some meat on them.
There's one that's 195, there's a 140, and then a 125.
It's tipped out at, call it, 2450.
Yikes.
Wow.
it's a par 33.
Hey, it's a nice little afternoon walk.
Oh, it's a par 33.
Yeah.
Oh, you over here talking about your 39.
Going back to our rating scale, guys, you know, a couple weeks ago, it's a 31.5.
Yikes.
So just real quick on that round, I was going to hole number nine, and I really wanted to break 40, you know, just to say I had a decent
Doesn't
hole.
Count.
John, shut up while I talk. So I'm going to hole nine. I think I need a bogey or better to shoot a 39. So I put my tee shot in the water. So
that's a great start.
I go to the drop zone and I get up and down for bogey. The drop zone was probably only 20 yards short of the green or so. So I was able to chip on, and then I made about an 8-footer to bogey the hole and shoot a 39. You know, it's fun to, when I'm not trying to shoot under par and have the best round of my life, to putt for something, you know. I was putting for a 40. So I, you know, I
doesn't
had a little
count.
Shut. Why doesn't it count, John?
Because it's par 33, Austin.
You come shoot a 39 there.
I bet I will.
The match 6.11.
John, I could beat you on this course. I know, like, the back of my hand.
Ooh.
It's dead straight.
It has.
See, I know John won't come out here because he's a little bitch, so.
Oh, my God. It's because I'm 32 and I have a job, Austin. I'm not a college kid that wakes up at noon every day.
Oh, you
like
can't?
You do.
Well, first of all, I'm not a college kid. I did, in fact, graduate.
You're close enough. Yeah, and you didn't graduate.
Did you graduate, though?
And you did not graduate.
John, you can come on a weekend. Come Friday after work.
I am busy. I have a life, Austin.
I've got a wife. He's got a wife.
You have a life or a wife?
Both.
You gotta. All right, whatever. Like I said, you're a little bitch. And you won't come play me.
Oh God.
Well, oh, speaking of you also coming in, we asked for your help with the smoker, and you won't come help. And we fucked up the ribs yesterday.
Because you bought the wrong fucking ribs. I'm sorry, you can't read the fucking book.
Oh, please, I want to hear this.
Oh, so here, I got a text, Cam. Let me tell the story. He's like, so I'll read the text because it's fucking hilarious.
Oh,
I didn't know what was going on at first. Where's it at here? Let me find it. So
talk about a real letdown. Can we just preface this whole entire thing?
Okay, so I get a picture of these ribs. Austin goes, it's like all bones and a ton of fat. What did I do wrong? I said, how long did you cook? He goes, 7 hours. I said, temperature? Is it the ribs? You move the silver skin, low and slow, everything. He goes, the little meat was there, it was good, 220. I think we bought the wrong ribs. We got spare ribs.
Short ribs.
Short
ribs. No, you got short ribs.
You bought short ribs.
You bought ribs and it wanted spare ribs.
That's hilarious.
Dude, so the little meat that we actually got to taste was phenomenal, but there was like...
I'm surprised it was still there.
Yes, after 7 hours.
7 hours? 20. I mean, did you wrap them?
No.
Oh my God. How was there anything left?
There just wasn't kidding. The way it sounded.
There was
consistent basting.
So they were eating barbecue sauce, basically.
Did you cook them at like 150 as well?
220.
Oh God.
Here, I have a picture. I have a picture of the ribs. The ribs themselves.
I want to see.
They don't
look bad. They don't look bad, honestly.
Yeah,
but
fine. But this is a great story.
So we bought the wrong rib. So
when you told me short ribs, I'm like, oh my God. We were somewhere and I'm like, Nicole, I said, Austin bought short ribs. She's like, are those the ones like they use in Korean cooking? I'm like, yes, those are the same ones. So,
dude, just talk about such a letdown. I left in the morning, and after I got everything rolling, I had to, you know, I turned the smoker on, went through the initial process, and I was like, hey, Ma, just throw the ribs on the smoker.
Mommy, low lid.
and I'll be back in a couple hours. I got to go pick up some beer from Ryan's house. So I got back, and they looked and smelled incredible. Now, I actually don't like ribs that much for whatever reason, but I was so fucking excited for these ribs. You guys have no idea. So we sit down at my grandparents' house because we cooked for my grandma and grandpa also, who live across the street.
They're like, these fucking kids don't know how to cook.
It was so disappointing. Austin had Cutco knives, and he's just fucking sawing through bones.
Oh,
it was just such a disappointment and such a letdown. That
honestly, with those spare ribs, the best way to eat them if you cooked them like that is just to pick them up and gnaw around the cartilage and spit the cartilage out.
That's what we tried doing. It just
So tomorrow we're gonna try a brisket. Yeah. Dean's gonna put it on.
You go from something hard to something even harder.
Yeah.
Well, how hard can it be to put a brisket on the smoker and let it smoke for 8 hours?
Yep. Did you read? Did you
go ahead? No. You are gonna document this, Austin. And I want to. I might give you some tips so that you don't, you know, kill your family because they don't have anything to eat. but seriously, document this, and I want to see what you do.
Document it on our Instagram and say
yes.
You will hear the rest of the story Wednesday in the podcast and rate Austin on how he cooked this brisket. Yeah,
explain it all in the stories.
So Dean can't post a hot dog, but I can take over the Instagram for a whole day about a brisket
because it's a fucking brisket, not a goddamn hot dog. That's a big difference.
Austin's defending me.
Yes, he is.
No, I just more wanted to stir the pot.
He's deflecting from going from ribs by short ribs.
Brisket doesn't sound very professional, so.
Enjoy eating that 8-hour smoked brisket at probably about 13. So let me know how that goes.
Pounder, right?
Yeah.
It's 6.5, I think, or 6.25.
But also when they bought the spare ribs and the brisket, they bought a pork shoulder butt. Dude, the thing is like 19 pounds.
Jeez. Pork shoulder's easy. Oh, 19 pounds? Oh,
yes.
Oh, my God.
That's what Costco had.
Jesus.
That's all they had?
Basically, they were all right around 15
pounds. You don't
have
to go to Costco.
And yet you get a 6-pound brisket?
Yeah, you got it backwards. You should get like an 8-pound pork butt and like a 15-pound brisket.
Anyways, so we're going to season up the brisket tonight. Dean's going to throw it on tomorrow before he leaves for
work. So what are you seasoning with?
Probably just salt and pepper.
Okay. You answered the first question correctly.
Okay, Aaron Franklin.
John, do you do the little mustard before the salt and pepper to take it or no?
No, just olive oil or an oil, canola oil. So, Austin, if you fuck this brisket up, you have YouTube and you have the fucking Aaron Franklin book that you bought. If you don't read
I forgot you have.
You have the book. If you fuck this up, then you will never hear the end of this.
Well, it's okay. So me and Dean were sitting outside talking about this and how, like, what time we're going to put it on and whatnot. With my sleep schedule's fucked up. So I was like, you know, 5 a.m. when I'm getting ready to go to bed, I'll just walk out here, turn the smoker on and crack open a beer and start cooking it.
If you start at 5 a.m., I will fuck wait. It up.
I'm if you start you that right thing now,
at 5 a.m., there's no fucking way. It's okay.
No, Dean's going to start it around 8:30-ish, 8.
So what, do you eat at 2 o'clock?
Oh, it's going to cook that fast?
It's like an hour and a half.
Per pound. An hour per pound at 6.5 pounds is 6.5 hours. You start at 8, you're going to eat at 2:30.
And it says an hour to an hour and a half per pound.
So if we go an hour and a half per pound,
that's
that
fine.
Puts us right
go
at 5:30.
Go ahead. That's fine.
I can't wait for that thing to stall. Do you know? Never mind.
Yes,
I know
what the stall is.
Let's let him figure it out.
Never mind.
I know what the stall is. All right. I've read.
Yeah, that's fine. What
the fucking short ribs and spare ribs are, you dipshit.
We bought them.
We're not from the cornfields or the south.
You're not from the cornfields. You're just fucking.
I'm sorry.
It's short ribs.
Pretty sure you just have to be alive to read.
In my defense, I did not pick them out.
Who did?
Because you were too lazy. You sat in the car when we went in.
Oh, yeah. You sat in the car like a kid.
It was like 100 degrees.
Hey, don't lie.
The smoker was in the bed of my truck. I didn't want anybody stealing the smoker.
I'd have loved to have seen somebody steal that smoker out of the back of your truck.
While Dean's sitting in the car. Dean wouldn't have done anything. What's he going to do?
Oh, God. So after you're going to do a brisket, which is the flat of the brisket you're cooking, what's the next thing you're going to cook? The 16-pound fucking... That's going to take fucking 20 hours and 80 pounds of pellets.
Can we cut it in half and cook it half and half?
It's probably bone in.
Can we grill it if we like?
No.
Whoa. Okay.
No.
Let's take a step back. I think you're getting worse. Just don't think. Just kind of move on to the next one. Next.
I think you should start with wings.
Well, we already started, and we.
Well, you fucked that one up. So go back to chicken wings.
Are chicken wings easy?
Yeah, they're easy.
So anyway,
elaborate.
Yeah, it's like I do them with
a thousand different ways.
Yeah, mine are like 350 both sides with some seasoning for like 15 minutes a side. I cook them slow and lower temperature, and then I will baste them or not and just open up the flame and kind of char them to finish them off last 10 minutes.
I bought a mop today, like a basting mop.
Those things are a fucking pain in the ass. They get all nasty.
Yeah, I know. This came with like four brushes.
Yeah.
Like the best one to get like a silicone basting mop, like the silicone fingers.
Uh-huh.
So.
Do you use butcher paper, John?
Barbecue. Yeah.
We bought some butcher paper, too.
Yeah. You gotta wrap yourself in it like the brisket?
For the brisket, should we wrap it before putting it on?
No.
Yes.
Yep.
Yes,
right away?
Yeah, yes. Absolutely.
Yes, no, I was reading the 3-2-1 method.
You fucking ask that question, Austin, when you have a goddamn barbecue book.
Oh, dude, just do what it says in the book. I guarantee you it'll be fine. Yeah,
do what it says.
Don't ask us because we're just going to make fun of you.
Tom, listen to this. So, did you hear about their barbecuing experiences?
Rip Austin's asshole. So
they made ribs. They bought short ribs thinking they were spare ribs. And
stop saying they.
You sit in the fucking car. You're just as much to blame.
You're guilty by association because you were lazy. So
I was guarding the smoker in my truck.
You're watching TikTok. You were guarding shit.
TikToker.
Where'd you bring the fucking grill that you had to guard it?
It was the day we bought it.
The south side.
It is buggy.
So Tom, they bought short ribs, thinking they were spare ribs. And Austin texts me, goes, "What the fuck is wrong with these ribs? They're really fatty and they're there's not much meat on them."
I don't think Tom knows.
Tom, do you know the difference between short ribs and spare ribs?
He's Googling it right now.
So, and then they're going to wrap the their brisket before they put it on the grill.
Well, no, I mean, they're just making sure they do something easier after the ribs, so.
I mean, I would not say a brisket's the easier. Oh,
I'm being completely sarcastic. Brisket's probably the hardest thing, at least for
me. I feel like if you watch enough videos and you kind of have a somewhat of an idea going into it, it can't be like
that's exactly like how we did the ribs.
It'll be edible. Listen. But by perfecting these things, you just have to do them.
Exactly. We're not saying it's going to be perfect, but the way we cooked the ribs was perfectly fine. We basted it like every hour, hour and a half with barbecue sauce.
I will
we
say,
kept
though,
it at a consistent temperature. We had it smoking very nicely.
You're probably better off with that higher temperature with the short ribs, because short ribs have a lot more connective tissue than spare ribs. So that higher temperature actually worked out in your favor over that 7 hours.
Yeah, I totally knew that. Duh.
Listen, these ribs were so fucking fatty that I was trying to rip them apart and they were squealing and like sliding out of my hands because they were so slippery from the fat.
We did get them up to 195 though, so they were the perfect temp.
Did they taste good?
Yes.
The meat was on them, yes.
Did you just lick the sauce off? And not actually eat
you
any
had
of
barbecued
it?
Barbecue sauce is what you had.
I'm pretty sure you just gnawed on it for like 3 chews and then spit it out. Mm, that tastes good.
So we are in fact a golf podcast. We are not a cooking or barbecue podcast. Do we want to give Tom an opportunity really fast for his?
No.
Okay. Whoa.
All right.
He wasn't here.
I don't know. I kind of want to talk about some barbecue now. I kind of
he has to deal with the pick we made for him. He wasn't here.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, so we made picks for the tour championship, Tom. Okay. That's in 3 weeks or 2 weeks or whatever. I picked JT. Cam and John both picked Morikawa. Dean picked
Bryson.
Bryson. And then we gave you Patrick Reed.
Cool. You know what? The best part of it is there is a potential for him to win, and you're all going to feel like absolute dog shit when he does.
Oh no, that's why he's ranked 6.
So we're gonna
he's
feel like when Paul more Casey than finished second,
right? No, dude, I was. The bus is cruising down Damon. We're looking really good that night.
And Tom, we also were discussing each of us throwing $10 on Zach Blair this week to win $25,000.
Yeah, no, fuck it. Absolutely. Why would you not?
So it'll be a $50 bet to win $25,000. We'd each
he just had
grand.
A kid, maybe, you know, who knows?
He's raring to go, man.
He's looking to play his way into the BMW.
The beef. I mean, shit. Yeah, let's do it. Who am I Venmoing?
Me.
Austin.
Tom, we were saying a year ago today is when Cam had Nick and Vito's for the first time.
Was it really a year today?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
We were at the BMW Championship the day Justin Thomas set the course record.
No shit. That was a fucking year ago?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
That's where right. Cam's life shit
show.
Sharp
wasn't that?
Yeah, shit show.
Right.
That was shit show weekend,
wasn't
everything's
in Cam's life started going wrong.
When he met you stooges.
Here we are.
Fucking yeah,
you're not far behind, John. Don't worry about it.
Wait, so, John, we were actually talking about this. I think me and Tom were, or me and Dean, I can't remember who it was. But, like, so Cam, we met because we went to Sweetens and whatnot. But, like, I don't remember, like, how we started talking to you more than just a shit show.
Yeah, I know. But we're not going to leave that off the record. So
John's an outsider.
Wait, do you remember, John?
Yes, I remember.
No, you were drunk the entire time.
Oh, yeah, because I had to organize that fucking event. So
Cam reached out to me about us when we planned that Sweetens trip.
Wait a second, John, you organized that event?
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, all right, well, let's move on to some hot spits and loud noises before we get too far off topic. I hope you guys enjoyed our smoker talk.
Why are we doing hot spits?
Just wait till the stories.
Did you like my initials for my picks?
Oh, are they all R's?
No, it's WAP.
Oh, wet ass pussy. Nice. So. Dude, that's a good strategy. I think I might start doing that because
Dude, it gets hard. It gets super hard.
Tom,
I'm telling you right now, it is really hard to try and put shit together with three fucking letters and last names.
You know how Dean picked Finau, who didn't play, Tom?
Yeah.
So John picked Lanto Griffin, who also didn't play.
You know what happens.
So, he withdrew after the fact.
You can't win them all, John.
I know.
He still had the best round of the
week. I'm still winning most of them. Oh, so we're into hot spits and loud noises.
Does anyone else have anything to add before we go on?
I was going to say, did anybody play this weekend? I didn't get a chance to get out at all.
I went out Sunday. Yeah, me and my wife went out.
Nice. So.
No, I feel like Austin and I were talking about going out and playing, and then I was talking to Dean about going out and playing, and it was just like, never fucking.
I almost reached out to play Sunday. Thank God I didn't, but that's a story.
Smoke them ribbies.
Also, Tom, it's a really good idea that you told my girlfriend not to let me drive home on Friday, because I got back to her place and I felt like I was hammered.
Yeah.
Well, oh, yeah, guess what I did this weekend? Speaking of that hammered Saturday.
Speaking of drinking and driving.
Drinking and driving. You know. So we went out to dinner Saturday night. I wanted to come home and watch the Stipe. What the fuck is his name? Cormier fight. So I'm trying to figure out how to get it ordered on my TV in the living room.
Were you drunk?
Look at you trying to do it the fucking legal way.
Is it on ESPN Plus?
Yes, but my fucking TV doesn't have ESPN Plus as an app, and then the Chromecast, I couldn't figure it out. So I went in the bedroom and used our Fire Stick.
I'm going to let you know a little secret here. ESPN Plus isn't an app. It's just ESPN app, and then you access ESPN Plus.
There's no ESPN app. There's no ESPN app for LG.
I bet you there's an ESPN app.
No, there's not. There's not an ESPN app for LG.
How do you think I watched the fucking major at work? I literally right then and there, I was like, fuck it. I'm just going to spend the $5.
Yeah, so but TV might not have it on there, Tom.
My TV doesn't have it, the app.
You could have
you
a stupid
said you
TV.
You have fucking Chromecast. I guarantee
no,
it's
no,
not
no,
there.
No, 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 no. I don't know
you
how.
Have a Fire
I tried
Stick?
To, I did in the bedroom, not, so I went, let me finish the fucking story. So I go in the bedroom.
You got a Fire Stick?
In the bedroom.
Fire Stick?
And I bought it, and within 5 minutes of buying it, I passed out.
Yeah,
literally,
that a boy.
I bought it, and then they started the first fight of the main card. And I laid there, and I like rolled my pillow so I could like watch it laying down. I'm like, oh, I'm gonna watch this, and then fucking passed out.
Did you have to order it? Was it like an extra charge, or was it just
it was
you had
$65? No,
yeah, it's an extra. And you don't get it for the $5 or whatever.
No, it was $65.
That's hilarious.
That's expensive.
That
night
is super.
Sleep.
Super unfortunate.
My wife the next day, she's like, so is that like a movie where you can watch it later? And I said, yes, it's like that. It doesn't mean anything now because I know the result, but yes, I can still watch it later.
So, guys, do you want to hear of the tentative menu at Breakfast at Tiffany's?
Yes.
Yeah, as long as
I think our listeners.
Spoiler alert.
Okay, so far.
Short ribs?
For breakfast. Yeah, we've got Austin on the smoker all day. All right.
You wanted us to lug our smoker all the way down there, John.
Because
so
I would
everyone's
be fucking running
be
it.
These are all subject to change, but I think it looks pretty good. So fried chicken and waffles with butter and honey, biscuits and gravy, fresh fruit, muffins, scrambled eggs and bacon if we want.
What kind of muffins?
Okay, so
fucking paid attention on all the options. Muffins?
It's just an assortment of muffins.
Fucking A.
You just ruined it.
Oh, the little Debbie's blueberry muffins.
I'm gonna bring you some zebra cakes. How about that?
What about some
cosmic brownies?
Cosmic brownies. Yes. Listen,
if it came down to a choice between a muffin or a fucking zebra cake, the zebra cakes win it every time.
They're so gross. Oh,
they're disgusting. No,
they're
muffin
so
ones for
gross.
Me.
Oh my god.
All right, and then we'll have Bloody Marys, mimosas.
Fuck yeah!
I've never had a Bloody
coffee.
Mary, actually.
You're
insane. I've also never had one, and I'm not going to start that weekend.
Yeah,
I don't blame
I'm not
you.
A fan.
I'll be and dabbling then... in the Malort first thing.
How many bottles of Malort do you want us to bring, Cam?
A case.
I don't
put
care.
My one on every hole.
Bring whatever you want. Bring whatever you want.
Can we go around before people get out there and put them on every tee box?
No.
I'm gonna bring two, one for each day. We'll figure out.
Oh god.
COVID we're not going to blow through that much.
Yeah, well, you know, it heard of some social COVID distancing rules. And whatnot.
For lunch, we're going to do a big taco bar.
Ooh. Fuck yeah.
With Chipotle chicken and carnitas. Yeah. And then just everything that you would imagine along with those. And then for dinner, gonna do steak with Parmesan peppercorn butter and farm grilled chicken.
Is it Outback steak?
You're gonna have bloomin' onions?
Actually, that'd be pretty sweet.
Can you imagine each person gets like a tiny little individual sized one?
If there's bloomin' onions involved, there's just gonna be shit streaks all the wrong sleeve.
There's yeah. already shit streaks with this menu all over the place.
I don't know. This is pretty dope. But yeah, and then potatoes, veggies, salad, rolls, and then we'll have some dessert. But yeah, that's kind of the tentative menu. I think it's pretty good.
And that's for Saturday?
That's the entire day.
And then is any food included Sunday or no?
No.
Are you grilling or is it all
Oh no, I've got a local. No, it's not Hattie B's. I've got a local guy that did breakfast and lunch for the member. So I gave him a call and worked something out. It's gonna be really fucking good.
That's Cam, awesome. This is where you say you're gonna be standing there shirtless at the grill with your straw hat on.
No one's more powerful than the guy.
Dude,
at the
grill. I'll definitely
pale ass forehead.
Yeah, I'll definitely have a straw hat on, but it's gonna
be. Dude, I watched Keith's story like at least 75 times of you stepping out of that car. I'm like, holy Jesus, this man's forehead is white.
It could be. He
screenshotted it and showed it to me.
It could be worse.
No, it's epic, dude. That is a solid fucking tan line.
So another drink idea I just saw today that sounds awesome with mimosas since it's the fall. I guess they said the new drink of the fall is going to be a fall-mosa, which is apple cider, fresh apple cider, and whiskey.
Hmm.
Isn't that kind of normal?
I've never heard of that before in my life.
Well, no, isn't like a hot cider? Isn't that like rum?
That's a hot toddy, isn't it?
A hottie toddy, right?
Hot toddy doesn't have anything apple in it, though.
I thought it was apple cider. Well, I don't know what it is.
No, it's.
So. No, I just always thought like a hot cider, like a spiked hot cider.
I was going to say, isn't hot toddy lemon?
Yeah, hot toddy's lemon.
You're like going to have any piece.
But you can have like spiked cider.
Yeah.
With, well, like,
I
mean,
I just thought it was like apple cider, spiced rum, some cinnamon.
That's usually what it is apple cider.
We're also forgetting October in Knox or South Pittsburgh, Tennessee. It's going to be like 100 degrees still. Like the first weekend.
Yeah, when the fuck were we down there? I don't even remember.
It was the last weekend in September.
Yeah, and it was like, what, fucking 98 with a heat index of 103.
Well, this time we'll have water, so.
not just White Claw.
Right. We had alcoholic seltzer water.
But that's literally all we had. And, you know, we didn't. Did we even eat?
We all made it.
No, yeah. We did. We got Wendy's.
No, before. Oh, we got Starbucks on the way down.
Afterwards, yeah. We went to Outback.
No, that was the next day we went to Outback.
That was the next day, yeah.
Oh, was it?
We got Wendy's after Sweetens.
It was all fucked up. I think I probably had a heat stroke.
All I know is that's the first time I've ever seen Tom dance in like the 8 years I've known him.
He also was dancing the other night when you recorded him in his webcam.
That wasn't the other night. That was quite a lot.
It was a couple months ago.
That was like right at the beginning of the lockdown where all you did all day was just wake up, drink, and then continue drinking, go to sleep, and then repeat.
Oh, yeah. Tom, by the way, I don't know if anyone filled you in, but for Hotspots today, we're doing boy bands.
I know. That's why I sent you my pick.
Okay.
Well, now you're here to tell us. So let's get rolling.
I believe we were doing 90s.
Oh, hold on.
We opened it up, but we can veto. Five sauce, Austin.
Hey.
No five sauce.
So we put out on our story today topics for the show, and one of the guys actually just brought up
Maybe we should have led with that.
Yeah, no, I just realized.
Fucking Christ. We've been doing this. This is episode like 75. We still don't have our shit together.
52 minutes in, we're finally answering listener questions. Continue, Gene.
Episode 382, and we forgot to do Hotspots this week.
Tyler J says, is it a shit move to play multiple balls when you're playing by yourself? Asking for a friend.
No, not at all.
Absolutely not.
No.
I guess
it's called practice.
I was going to say it would come down to how fast they're playing behind you, though, right? Like, if you have people behind you. Like
answer that was, no.
I mean, if you get the people waiting on you, then you're just an asshole.
That's
but
what
I would
saying.
Assume if you're keeping with the pace, then fuck it. Have at it, dude. Hit as many fucking golf balls as you want.
I don't even keep score when I'm playing by myself. Usually, it's just kind of practicing with a couple balls.
I think we're all on the same page.
If you keep pace, you can play 100 balls.
Hey, Tom.
There is definitely going to be someone out there listening that's having a fucking fit right now.
I just play by myself, John.
Hit multiple balls? Can't do that.
Don't you know golf etiquette?
Right. Having fun playing golf? Are you out of your fucking mind?
All right, let's get the hot spits here, guys.
So it was Cam's idea. I think it's only fair that he leads us off.
Also, sorry if we didn't get to your question. We had a ton of them this week, if you couldn't tell. Be sure to send them in again next week, and we'll try our best to get to some more.
Like, we'll actually try. John will be in charge next week. He's good at planning things.
Cam, what's here? What's your pick?
Are you sure you're ready, Dean? I mean,
I'm okay.
I don't think you're done pissing all over yourself right now.
Right. I like how you lead it off with, "Oh, it was Cam's idea this week, so we'll let him lead it off." What's the fucking idea, Dean?
The boy band genre, Tom.
Oh my! Wow, you didn't even okay.
So this week we're doing boy bands for our hot spits and loud noises. We got a couple requests via our DMs. We'll get to them eventually, I promise. But this week, we're going to start off with something nice and easy. So, Cam.
Wait, so we had DMs and no one was going to share that?
No, it was.
That would have been cool.
Because we actually didn't have.
That was a joke. Because, well, DMs.
I recommend that we do genres. Shout out to Jay.
Yeah, I bet we did have some and you just didn't look. I blame
you. So I did look. Grant said we should do decades. So this we were
boy bands it is. All right, shut up. All right,
listen, Grant, we see your request and we give you an eh.
We'll get there eventually.
We'll get there. Sure, we'll decade. Do, I mean, this was 80s. A decade for the most part. Half a decade.
Well, for real.
90s boy bands.
All right. I'm gonna go Pop by NSYNC.
Ooh.
All right. I'm gonna go with the most basic.
Wait. Called Pop?
Yeah, it's called Pop.
You sure it's okay. Not Dirty Pop?
No,
it's I'm positive Pop. Because it's I looked Pop. For Dirty Pop and it's not there. It's Pop. Believe me.
Okay.
Okay. So I'm going to go with the most basic pick you could ever have.
I swear to God, Austin.
I'm going with I Want It That Way by the Backstreet Boys.
Okay, no,
that's mine. Are you even alive for that song, Austin, you or are... not? I don't think you were alive for that.
Fire.
Oh my gosh.
What year were you born, Austin?
That's information you'd like to know, isn't it?
It would have been 98. You were fucking, what, 3 when that came out?
No, four? I was 1. I was actually 1. You can do basic math. 99 minus 98 is
came out and came in 99. So,
Pop by NSYNC. Oh, are you talking about your pick, Austin?
Austin's pick.
Okay, I was going to say Cam's came. Austin, did Cam's you even graduate?
All right,
we covered that.
All right, Tom, John, Dean.
I will take the absolute softball and go yard with it. I'm going to take Hanson.
How dare you steal my song?
Yes.
Dirty
just
whore.
An absolute softball on taking yard. Hanson, bop. Almost 100 million plays on
YouTube. Way to pander.
I'm going with Backstreet Boys, Larger Than Life.
Did your wife pick that?
No, I did.
John is known for giving other people his picks.
Tom? All right.
Tom, wrap us up.
Oh, now it's on to me?
Yeah.
You're the last better one. Not be right. Backstreet Boys, because they were
It's obviously the easiest one to close out anything with. NSYNC.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Good boy.
Well, on that note, Dean, take us out.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, hopefully you guys enjoyed this week's episode. Not a lot of golf, a decent amount of brisket and rib talk this week. Shout out to you guys, though, for real. You guys bought the last bag of tees this past Sunday, so that is our first ever sellout for our merches.
Our merches.
What is that noise? Who keeps going? Does anybody else hear that?
It's the fucking chipmunk, dude. Don't question it.
Anyway, no, but for real, you guys are awesome. Thank you guys for enjoying what we're doing. We're having a blast with it. Hopefully you guys are around for a little bit longer to see what else is. What? Who keeps doing that?
I don't know, but that shit is fucking funny.
Who keeps doing that?
Oh my god.
All right, we'll see you guys next week. Take it easy.
Make sure you like and subscribe.
Bye, bye, bye. That was a good one.